Hi all. Welcome to the session. I got, you know, many requests. Okay, people, you know, coming to Hyderabad, Amirpet, you know, and learning so many courses. Okay, not getting the job and learning one more course, not getting the job. Okay, so and learning one more course, not getting the job. Then somebody else will say that, you know, he got job on so and so technology and he'll go and learn that and not getting the job like that. Okay, so many people, okay, practically thousands or even lakhs of the people I have seen from last, you know, 16 years. People, he, okay, one friend says, hey, that friend got job, okay, after learning this course. Then he will go and join. He don't get job. Then some other friend will say, hey, this course, you know, he got job and he go and join there and he don't get job. So actually, I want to, you know, give the tips how to get software job easily. Okay. In very, very, very simple steps, just 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. So how to get software job easily? Anyone, anyone. And, you know, software job is very lucrative job, you know. It is one of the, you know, prestigious job and it is one of the, you know, the highest salary job actually. Okay. Okay. Now I want to tell, okay, how to get software job in 4 easy steps. Okay. Okay. And before going to that, I want to tell a few myths of software job. Okay. First one is myths of software job means what are the false conceptions that people have about the software job? Okay. And I mean, what people think about it. Okay. And I mean, what type of fears they have. Okay. So, I mean, why they're not able to get the confidence or why they're not able to get the job. Okay. Because of these fears. Okay. I will tell you that. That is also very, very important. And then who is eligible for software job? Okay. So many people has this doubt. Okay. Maybe software job is not for me, or this may be for, you know, who already studied BTech or MCA or something else, or maybe higher education, something like that. Okay. In that, I'm going to tell who is eligible for software job. In number 3, how to get software job easily. This is very, very important among all this list, how to get software job easily. Okay. So, and then how the salary ranges of software job. Okay. Like some people who want to know, you know, how much salary I'll get. Okay. So how my life will be. So that thing we'll discuss in the last part of this video. Okay, let's start with myths of software job. Okay, so many people think software job is, you know, coding. We need coding. Coding means like, you know, C, C++, Java, .NET, or HTML, or Python. Okay, nowadays, okay, Python or PySpark. Okay, so recently Python, PySpark, you know, these became Spark, these became famous. So many people think, you know, we need coding, then only we can get the software job. That's wrong. Okay. That means you don't have idea about what, I mean, you don't have idea about what happens in the IT industry or what are the different roles that are available in the IT industry. Okay. Yes, whatever you know is right. Okay. There is coding is required, but all the 100% people of software engineers, they are not the coders. Okay. They are not the programmers. Okay. If someone has programming skills, yes, he can go for programming job. Okay. So, okay. If you're not good in programming, which is already, you know, 95% people are not good in programming, even including me. Okay. I'm not good in programming, but I'm earning the highest salary in the IT industry. Okay. At least one of the top 5% of the, you know, population, I'll be there. Okay. So I'm not a good programmer. So the myth is we should know the programming. No, you don't have to worry about it and you don't have to know about it, the programming. Okay. Then what is the way? And another myth is, oh, it is very, you know, tension or a lot of pressure. Like that people will think. Okay, a lot of pressure will be there in IT. No, that's not right. You see, anything will be pressure if you don't know how to do that. Okay, if you don't know how to do that. And especially if you are a programming, okay, if you are in programming jobs, yes, programmings, you know, a lot of production releases will be there, you know, a lot of testing will be there. So that job is definitely, you know, little pressure and a little complex than the other roles. First of all, why did you go get into that role? Okay, why did you get into the, you know, where a lot of pressure and a lot of, you know, tension will be there? Don't get into that role. So then your life will be cool. Your life will be cool. Then the next question is, are there any roles which are without programming? Yes, there. In fact, programming roles are only some 40%. Programming roles are 40%. Remaining all are 60% of the jobs are without programming. Or programming roles are up to 25%. Okay. So coding is only one part of the, you know, IT life cycle. Okay. The remaining 75%, you don't have to do any programming. Okay. So are there any jobs which will pay good salary in software? Yes. Even you don't know programming, there are very good jobs which are giving more salaries than the programmers. For example, I'll tell you, database jobs. Okay. Means database jobs means, like, you know, databases, like, okay, and cloud databases and data warehouse related jobs. Okay. For example, if you see my video, my channel, I train on, you know, AWS Redshift, Snowflake, okay, BigQuery. And earlier I was training on Teradata. These are all database and data warehouse related topics. You don't have to know any programming. Just you need to know SQL. And SQL is, you know, very simple. Okay. SQL is the easiest job. If you know select statement, that's it. If you know DML, okay. I mean, if you basic insert, update, delete statements, that's it. And that is only, you know, first within 2-3 months, you will learn it. That's it. Once you know that, you can live entire your life. For example, I started my career on database, okay, database and data warehouse. And initial career only, I learned, okay, SQL and all. That's it. On the SQL only, I'm leading my whole life. Even now, I'm doing the same job, which is that easy for me. Because you're doing years and years on the same SQL related job, okay? And you know how to do and everything. So I never feel my job is tension or anything because the same thing. But if you're a programmer, definitely, you know, it's a hectic. So you need to know what are the jobs, okay, where you don't have tension or pressure, okay? And one area is databases and data warehouse related. And the other area is BI related tools. Okay, BI means business intelligence tools, reporting tools. Okay, reporting tools means like, you know, Tableau, okay, Microsoft Power BI. Okay, so BODS, business objects. Okay, like reporting tool or Cognos or AWS QuickSight. Okay, these are all BI tools. Okay, they are little easier than the, again, programmers. Okay, you don't have to know any coding or anything. You just need to know how to use that BI tool. Okay, so two areas I said, database and data warehouse, and the other one is BI tools. Then your life will be cool. That's it. Okay, and your salary is also very, very high. Okay, you don't have to worry about it. Automatically, as you start working, initially, you may get maybe 6 lakhs, 8 lakhs. Okay, whatever maybe. I mean, if it is a good company, you will get even 12 lakhs as a starter. But as you get experience, you even reach 30 lakhs, 40 lakhs, 50 lakhs salaries as you gain experience. And as you gain, okay, senior levels like, you know, architect, data modeling, these are the advanced concepts, which even I teach in my videos. If you know the advanced concepts like, you know, how to do data modeling, how to do architecting, okay, then you will get even reach 60 lakhs, 70 lakhs CTCs, okay. So in fact, many of the people, real-time people join my sessions, okay, only for, you know, architecting or how to become a solution architect or how to do data migrations, cloud migrations. Already working people who are already getting 25 lakhs, 30 lakhs salary, they want to get high salary. They just come and join, take session for 1 week or 2 weeks, or they want to know certain things as a solution architect and they learn it and they get like 40 lakhs, 50 lakhs. Okay, very easy. You don't have to worry about it. Okay, that it is difficult. It is a lot of pressure and all. No. Okay. The secret is you have to be in the right position or right role. Okay. If you know that you're not a programmer, don't get into the programmer roles and even don't learn AI also. Okay. The easiest role is database and data warehouse. And then the similar easiest job is BI roles. Okay. Like reporting tools. Okay. That one. And believe me, there is no pressure. Okay. Pressure is because you're in wrong role. Okay. And you don't know how to do the job. Okay. You should know what is required for your job. And if you're master it, you just play it. You just, you know, work for 1 hour a day. That's it. You complete all the work. And remaining is just enjoy the life and enjoy the, you know, spend time with family and all. So don't think that, you know, software is, you know, difficult job. I cannot get it or I need programming skills or, you know, it is a lot of tension. No, that's not the thing. That is the case with the programmers, you know, who work with some programming, because programmers means they have to, you know, write the code, test it. And then if there are any bugs, they have to again retest it. And, you know, a lot of releases will be there. So that's where their life is like that. But we should be intelligent enough to choose other roles, okay, which are not hectic like this. And other roles, I said, there are many roles, okay, related to database and data warehouse and, you know, BI, okay. I will tell you that also, okay, within that, what jobs to select, okay, that I will tell you again. Because although there are other, what do you know, which is better and how to get job within that skill. So that I will tell that point again. Then who is eligible for software job? That is point number two. Who is eligible for software job? Many people will think that, you know, oh, I have studied only degree or BSc or BCom or I mean, you know, literate, something like, you know, language, okay, MA, okay, English, something like, okay, or I'm a pharmacy, okay, I'm a, so like, you know, science student, biology student, or I'm a math student. Okay. Can I get software job? The beauty of software job is everybody is eligible. In fact, I have seen those people who are not getting job, they're all coming and, you know, getting job. Even pharmacy students. Okay. Even pharmacy students, even math students, even English people, or even social studies people, they're all coming and, you know, getting the software job. I will tell you how is it possible? Because software, they never see, okay, what is your this one, okay? Only thing is you should be able to answer the entry questions. That's it. It doesn't matter, okay? They need, okay, some companies will look for, you know, 10 plus 2 plus 3 means degree, 10 plus 2 plus 4 means BTech or anything, something like that, 16 years of education. Or for that matter, any degree. Okay, it doesn't matter your math, science, or BSc computers, nothing. Okay, and 10 plus 2 plus 4 means BTech or any 4 years degree. It may not be software engineering or IT or CSE, nothing like that. You can be ECE, EEE, civil, chemical, anything. You have seen, right? Many of your friends, even he is chemical engineer, mechanical engineer, they are doing software jobs. So you just either degree or BTech. Okay, so these. Then even if you have MCA, MBA, okay, I mean, PhD, what doesn't matter, whatever you are, you can easily eligible for software job. Okay, you don't have to worry about, I'm an MBA, can I get it? Yes, you are most welcome. In fact, they're already doing, okay, I'm a MPharmC, yes, you're eligible. I'm a BPharmC, yes, you're eligible. Anything, okay, even MBA, MBBS doctor also can get software job. In fact, there are people like that in America, in USA, okay. So whatever your qualification or whatever your education, okay, I mean, of course, minimum degree, okay, degree will be there, okay, so it any degree, even maths also fine, okay, so you are eligible, even 4 years degree, then well and good, okay, so it doesn't matter, you don't have to be CSE, IT, or, you know, anything, you can be even maths, okay, or you can be physics, you can be social studies or anything. Okay. So anyone with 10 plus 2 plus 3 means degree or 10 plus 2 plus 4 or BTech or even degree plus, you know, MSc, MCA or anything. Okay. You are eligible to get this software job. Okay. Then, okay. That means now, I mean, nowadays, you see, everyone is studied at least degree. or everyone is studied, you know, BTECs, MTECs, even MSc, MCA, MBA, everyone is studied. So you have all the qualifications. Then the critical thing, how to get software job easily. This is, you know, very, very important. Everyone knows that, you know, he got job, she got job. Okay, everyone is getting job. And so you went there and you learned, okay, and you did not get the job. Okay, so that is one way of getting job means, okay, your friend got job, you went there and you learned, okay. Of course, there are some people, okay, who got succeeded, they got the job. Okay, and there are some people who did not get the job after getting trained there. I will tell even within that option, I'm telling how to get software job easily. Easily means this place major important because you can learn course from anyone. Okay, because there are many people who teach, right? So anyone, but that person, if he is working on the skill he is teaching, okay, he must work on that skill or technology. Okay. So if he is working on that, okay, if how to get software job easily, you can learn from anyone, but the person who is teaching, he must be working on the technology. Okay. For example, I'm teaching on the database or data warehousing. I must be working on that. In that, what happens? I know, okay, what I'm doing, okay, in my real-time project. I know what is the issues I'm facing. Okay. I know. Okay. In fact, I also will take interviews, questions. So I will ask these, I will teach the same thing to these people. So that's it. Easy ticket. Because I'm teaching the same thing, what I'm using in this technology, and same questions will come and he will be selected. Okay. And because most of the people in outside, they teach something because it's very, you know, hot in the market, but they might not be working on that. Okay. So he might be working on a different technology. Then it will be little difficult because he is not working on the skill he is teaching. So he may not know, you know, real time things within the technology. Okay. So for example, okay, how to get software job easily. Okay. I'm teaching on Snowflake and Redshift. Okay. Both are cloud data warehouses. Because earlier I was working on-premises data warehouse. Okay. That is Teradata. And then I started working on Redshift. And then I started working on Snowflake. Okay. Since I'm working on Snowflake, so I'm teaching Snowflake. So I know what is the development, you know, how, you know, software job or development work in Snowflake. You know, how to develop jobs or, you know, how to architect in Snowflake, how to migrate data on Snowflake. So I know all these things because I'm doing it. So if I teach the same to the people, they also can get the job easily because they will be presenting what I said in the interview. That's it. Interviewer, he cannot suspect that he is fake because he is exactly presenting what I said. So although you can get software job easily by joining anywhere, okay, yeah, that way also you can get job. But the most easiest way is learning from a candidate, okay, who is already working on the same technology, okay, what he is teaching. Okay, for example, X person is teaching, okay, some Y technology. Then he must be working on that Y technology. Then only he knows, you know, how to do development on Y technology. Okay. What is the life cycle? Okay. How to do the testing, how to fix the issues in that. All those things he knows because he's already doing right now. Same thing. For example, if I'm working on, okay, Redshift or Snowflake, I know actually what issues we'll get, how to fix it. Okay. So that I can teach you. And you also will present the same thing in the interview. So that is the easy way. For example, let's say I'm working on Snowflake right now, but I have to teach Azure or I have to teach, okay, something else, okay, Power BI. I may, you see, because you know, I'm educated, so I may learn, you know, Power BI and teach. But definitely, I am not effective like, you know, Power BI expert, right? Who is already working on Power BI. Same thing. Okay. So that's what, you know, in fact, that is the uniqueness of my, you know, training. I teach only on what I work. Okay. Earlier, I was working on Teradata. At that time, I used to train Teradata. Later on, I was working on AWS Redshift. I used to train that. And now I'm working on Snowflake. So I'm giving training on Snowflake. Okay. So Amen. Not only me, anyone. Okay. Wherever you join, ask him, okay, whether he's working on the same technology. If he's working on the same technology, and yeah, that is one thing. But if he just teaches you and leaves it, then also it is very difficult to get the job. Why? Because you see, if he just teaches you and leaves it, how do you know what is the entry questions will come, how to answer, what is the real-time questions on the technology? I mean, because you are new to software, so definitely you don't know. So the faculty or the trainer must be able to give his time to help you to get the job, which is not possible in the, you know, generally institutes. Okay, they'll just teach. Yeah, they teach very nicely everything, but after that, they leave it. Okay, the student, again, you know, you don't know actually how to get the job. So basically, if any person or any trainer, if he can spend his time, okay, if he can give, okay, his time guiding this guidance is very important, guiding the student, okay, how to get the software job once the training is done. Training is done, okay, anybody, okay. But after that, he should be able to guide him. Okay, he should be able to, you know, tell him, okay, these are the entry questions that will come. Okay, this is the way you need to present it. Okay, and you know, so this, because that guidance is called actually the junction or the, what is that? The joint between student and the job. Okay, it will help him like a bridge to get onto the job. Okay, because just learning the topic does not actually help the student unless he is provided with proper guidance, how to apply for the interviews, and you know, how to give the interviews. Okay, how to give the interviews. And definitely in interview, he will get some questions which he cannot answer. So those questions, the trainer should be able to help him, okay, how to answer that. So that gap should be built by the trainer. Once, okay, if he can give that kind of guidance, it's very easy for him to get the job. Because the theory training is theory. Okay. Interview, you will get some real-time scenarios, real-time. So that bridge, actually, student cannot build that or, you know, fill that gap. So the trainer who is already working on the technology should be able to fill that gap. Okay. Then, okay, student will easily understand. Okay. This is the way I should present if this question comes. If any trainer who can give that kind of guidance, you can blindly join him. Okay. And here there are two plus points. First, he's already working on the technology. Second one, after the technology, he's not leaving you. Okay. He is helping you to understand the real time. Okay. Connection between the theory subjects and the real time entry questions. Okay. And once you get such kind of faculty, you must blindly follow him and you must present the way he teaches, because he's training with, you know, a lot of experience. The way if you can present, okay, the way he teaches, same wording, if you can present, that's it. Nobody can reject you. Nobody can reject you. Okay. So, okay. How to get software job easily? First one, okay. You should be trained by a person who is already working on the technology. Okay. Whatever technology it may be. Okay. So, and second one, okay. The faculty or trainer must be able to help you or guide you. Okay, how to answer the real-time questions, okay, and how to address, you know, whatever the scenarios, because scenarios are based on real-time project. Okay, till now, whatever we covered is a theory. So that real-time oriented training should be there, and that gap he should be able to fill, okay, through guidance. He should be able to tell. If you see my videos, you will know, okay, how I teach. Okay, every concept I will tell how that concept is implemented in real time and what you will be doing there. Okay, so that you will not feel like you are fake actually. You're actually doing the same thing what he is doing, and you actually fix the issues the same way that he is fixing in his project. So interviewer also, he cannot think that you are fake, because whatever his real-time questions he is asking, you are answering as you are already doing. So that is the best way of getting the software job easily. Okay, it doesn't matter what background you are. And next one, how the salary ranges of software job. As you people know, you know, nowadays you see outside, even you take pharma jobs, teaching jobs, any jobs, okay, they're not paying much. Salary in software industry is really good. Okay, really, really good. In fact, you have seen some people get software, you know, campus interview. If you take in US jobs, I mean, sometimes we get newspaper ad, he got 1.5 CR, okay, 1.4 CR like that. Yeah, in USA, since they pay dollars, so it will be that much. In India also, we get, you know, 6 lakhs as a fresher, 8 lakhs, 10 lakhs, even 15 lakhs, 16 lakhs. If you are employed with, if you get job in AWS, I mean, Amazon, you will get even 16 lakhs as a starting salary. Okay, other companies, they do pay even 12 lakhs, 10 lakhs, 6 lakhs. Of course, if you get job in like, you know, Tech Mahindra, Wipro, Infosys, TCS, they will pay up to, you know, 3 lakhs or 2.8 lakhs like that as a starting package. But whatever the starting package, okay, it is advised to join, because that's only a beginning. Once you get into this job, okay, after you get or gains little experience, like 1 year, 2 year, you will be a master, because you should keep, you know, learning. Learning means you should find the, you know, proper guide or mentor, like, for example, experienced people. Okay. For example, there are many people with a lot of experience. For example, even I myself teach, you know, software, about software and architect level discussions. Okay. Data modeling level discussions. Even people with 12 years, 15 years, 16 years, they join my sessions, because I have something which they don't have or which others don't know. Because in IT, you don't get opportunity to work on those roles. That is the reason, although they are working from last 12 years, 15 years, they did not get the chance to do that role. That's why they are not able to perform. So whatever you are lagging or you did not get chance to work on, you have to know those roles, or you have to get training on those roles. For example, you did not get opportunity to work on data modeling. Then you should learn, okay, about data modeling. For example, you did not get chance to work on performance optimization, exclusive performance optimization. Then you should learn, okay, about that. For example, you did not get chance, although you have 15 years of experience, you did not get chance on to work as a solution architect, or you did not get chance to work on a migration architect. You get, you know, training on that. Then this person will teach you, okay, how to do that. Then you can apply on that solution architect or migration architect or even performance tuning specialist roles. That's it. Your salary will become immediately double. Or even at least you can get from, okay, 70 to 80% high. Because I have such kind of students. One candidate joined with, you know, 25 lakh salary. I mean, his salary is already 25 lakhs. He said, sir, I'm expecting, you know, around 33 lakhs, sir, after this training. Like that, he said, he's already, you know, working very good company. Okay, he's working for VMware. Okay, from last 7 years, he's working there. And he was getting 25 lakhs. Then he said, okay. In fact, he was already following my videos and all. He already, you know, senior, okay, 9 years, 10 years experience. Then he joined. After joining my sessions, within 3 weeks, he got 41 lakh CTC within 3 weeks only. Actually, he's expecting, he's happy if he gets 33 lakh CTC, but he got 41 lakh CTC. He was, you know, very, very happy. He was ecstatic. He said, yeah, sir, thank you very much, sir. I will be in contact with you every day. Okay. Because I also don't have any friends. Okay. I'll be in contact with you, like that, he told me. In fact, every student of mine is still in contact with me, because whenever they need any guidance, of course, they sometimes check with me first. Okay. So, yeah. So that is the, you know, best use case. Okay. A person with 25 lakh salary, he's expecting only 33 lakhs, but he got 41 lakhs. That is really, you know, outstanding. Of course, there are many people, even some of my students are in USA also. Okay. I'm just telling, okay, one or two example. Salary ranges, initially you may get, you know, whatever salary, but later on, if you're just doing in the same role, you know, okay, chalta, okay, everything going cool. Then you see, you cannot grow, right? You have to learn what you don't know. Okay, what you don't know means, for example, you need to explore performance tuning kind of things, okay, cloud migration kind of things, a software solution architect, okay, how to become a solution architect in the technology, okay. So those things you should explore. In fact, that is the end actually. If you know solution architect means you know actually, okay, you know, okay, how to, okay, how to provide software or how to customize, you know, servers, okay, how to reduce the cost to the company. So all these things, you know, so management will depend on you. Okay, they will ask your advice. Hey, here so much cost is coming. Can you see if you can reduce the cost? That's where solution architect, that's where they get a lot of, you know, lot of salaries. Okay, you should be in the top list. Okay, that means you need to know certain areas. Okay, this point I'm telling, after you gain 8 years, 9 years of experience, or after 6 years of experience, okay, how to increase your salary even further and further and further. That, okay, further I'm telling this. Okay, so yeah, salary ranges, you see, whatever your expectation, you can easily reach within the IT industry. In fact, you can easily go to USA if you want to dream of it. Okay, or if you want to, even within India only, okay, you can get, even you can get in within India only 1 CR job. Okay, if you have the right skills. Or of course, 40 to 60 lakhs is the normal you will get. If you have 10 years or 8 years experience, with, you know, proper skills. What is the proper skills? Performance optimization, cloud migration, and solution architect kind of thing. Okay, even you are not a programmer, no problem. But you have to begin somewhere, right? You have to start somewhere. Okay, so begin somewhere. So I hope you all understood, okay, the myths of the software job, and am I eligible or not for the software job, how to get software job easily, and you know, what are the salary ranges. And one more thing I want to tell, in who is eligible for software job, many people think, oh, I have a lot of gap. Okay, a lot of gap. Yeah, am I eligible? I completed my BTech in 2005. Now 15 years gap came. Am I eligible? Can I get the job? Who is worried about your gap? These are all because you don't know about the software industry. What software industry people look for is from last, okay, whatever experience you're claiming, 3 years, 4 years, 5 years, from the last 4 years, are you working or not? That's what it matters. You may be passed out in 2005, but you may be in 2005 to maybe 2015. Okay, you may be doing something else. You can tell I did some my business. Okay, I did something else, or I'm married, I have children. Okay, later on, you know, I started my career. This is especially for, you know, housewives and people who want to move to, okay, software industry. Don't worry about your gap. This is what I'm telling in the point number three, guidance. Guidance, okay? The trainer, the expert trainer can guide you, okay? How to cover your gap, okay? How to positively turn your gap, okay? To fetch the software job. Don't worry about your gap. Some, and another use case is, some people will say, sir, I lost job in last year, but I still did not get job, okay? How to answer this? Yeah, you can answer that. Okay. So yeah, there are many reasons, boss. Okay. So I will tell you actually all those things. It depends on one-to-one actually. Okay. It varies based on person to person. Okay. So I interact with the person and I understand, you know, or maybe based on he or she. Okay. Maybe. Okay. Based on, okay. So, and what she did during that gap, I will advise them actually. Okay. How to positively fill that gap. So that interviewer, he don't think, okay, from last 1 year. You say, just, you know, I did not get job. That means you are not worthy. You should tell in such a way that, you know, he don't think that's a gap. In fact, that's not a disqualification. It's a 1 year gap, you see. If anybody will get 1 year gap, 6 months gap, okay, after the job, okay? So you should tell positively that, you know, I went, maybe I went some, you know, USA, or, you know, I was learning some course, okay? So, or we went with family somewhere outside, or, you know, I was on vacation, okay? Or some, you know, medical, you know, issues in the family, okay? Or I just want rest, that's it. Even if you're performing interview properly, even you say, I'm taking break, nobody will reject. In fact, I say like that. I mean, I never had break, but I'm telling. If you are sound in knowledge in giving the entry, you can tell, yeah, I have taken break. Okay, I have taken break. They'll accept it. because your entry performance say that you're an outstanding candidate. So that gap and all doesn't matter. In fact, I know, okay, some ladies, they take, you know, paternity leave. Okay. I mean, they gave birth to some baby and they take 1 year gap, but they are still hired by the companies. 1 year hired, you know, 1 year gap, it doesn't, you know, prevent you to fetch the job. What they need is how you are performing. Okay. So my dear friends, don't worry whether you have a gap in your career, and don't worry even if you have a recent gap because of losing job or whatever reason, or maybe because of, you know, paternity leave or whatever it may be. Okay. Or if you want to start a good start, means you're already from us, you married and you did not think about doing his job. Now you want to get started. Don't worry about it. You can easily get started. But the thing is, you have to learn from a person who is already working on the technology. And second point is, he should be able to help you and guide you. Then you can get the job in just 2 to 3 months. Just in 2 to 3 months, you'll get the job. Okay. And I already said, minimum you will get, if you are a fresher, you will minimum you will get, you know, 3 lakhs ETC, 4 lakhs ETC. I mean, based on the company. If you're trying on experience, you will minimum get nowadays, you know, for example, my students, they are getting 15 lakhs, 12 to 15 lakhs if they are trying on 3 to 4 years experience. 12 to 15 lakhs as the starting salary. And all the 3 to 4 years is again a fake experience. Okay. So yeah, based on for freshers, it is really good. If you want to try on experience, yeah. So based on the skill, you will get the job. Okay. If you are learning, you know, some testing or, you know, some Oracle or MySQL and all, you know, you will not be offered that much salary. But if you're learning, you know, cloud technologies, okay, cloud technologies, because these are all very niche skills. Okay. Then you will be hired. Okay. I'm telling, right. One of my students got 15 lakhs with, you know, she has only 1 year experience, but she claimed some, you know, 3-4 years of experience. She got 15 lakhs. Okay. Like that. So yeah. So based on it all depends on, you know, the guidance of a person who is already working in the technology and who is teaching the technology. If you follow his guidance, it is damn sure anybody can get the job in 2 to 3 months. Okay. I mean, if you're lucky, you will get it within just 1 month only. Okay. Sure. Now, this is what the message I want to give. Okay. If you have anyone looking for software job, or if you are looking for software job, or if you think this video will help anyone, please. Okay. Subscribe first. Okay. You like it first. If you like it. If you don't like it, that's fine. But I'm sure this is useful for many of the, you know, people. Okay. I know because you know, I deal with a lot of students. Okay. So because of lack of guidance only, you know, they are learning so many courses, spending a lot of money, but not getting any job. Even some people are paying money thinking that they will give the job. Okay. But they're not getting job because you have to join with a person who is already working on the technology. Okay. If you think this video will help anyone, just share this video, like, share, and subscribe my channel, follow my channel. Okay. I'm sure if you are serious, you can get this software job easily. Okay. So in my channel, you have my contact number. You can just, you know, WhatsApp me if you're really serious about the software job. Thank you all. Okay. So thanks and okay. See you.